Well, you know, my question to Ed is always, who are the guys you were looking up to? Because there were racers, but there weren't freestylers out there, you know? So Ed, what gave you your inspiration to do what you do?
Let's see. So, like everyone, I started racing back in the day. I wasn't that fast, but I did do a bunch of jumps, and I liked jumping and the air aspect, that feel, right, and the style. Since I wasn't winning the race, I'd actually back off a little bit and do a 360 over the last couple jumps. And I thought to myself, no one remembered the guy in front. They saw the guy doing the 360, they remembered me. So that's where I started doing more of the skate park things and riding, and it was just, you know, just that, I don't know what you call it. I mean, like, everybody knows that ride feel. Like, when you land, it's kind of like playing golf. If you hit that ball and it feels right that one time that you hit, when you land that jump and you land the backside of that air and everything's nice and smooth, it's like, oh, I got to do that again. So you just keep doing it and you go a little bit higher, a little bit higher. And the thing is that back in the day, nobody did it before us. There wasn't anybody that I saw. There was no magazines that had pictures of guys busting big air. We didn't.
So I've become friends with Eddie's mother over the years, and she talked to me about this ramp in your driveway. And it struck me that if it weren't for her going, yeah, Eddie, you can build the ramp in my driveway, and have your knuckleheaded friends come in and, you know, smash their head on the pavement. She let that happen, and so really, it's your mom.
Oh yeah.
You know, that is responsible.
So my house, it was a regular street, and then you had to make a right-hand turn into the driveway. The house had a big, huge window out in front. Perfect, you're eating breakfast, you can see out the window. Not anymore. Huge ramp in the front, checkerboard. You know, everybody knew where I lived.
But that's ground zero. I mean, that's hollow ground. That's where it started.
Yeah.
And that was her grace going, yeah, that's a good idea. It's really cool, man. I love it.
Is that a shandy?
Yep.
Thank you.
Cheers, guys. Thanks for having us out. We wouldn't be here if it wasn't for you. We hope to come back next year with our friend Martin Abrejo. All right? And we love you. We're gonna turn this over to John, I guess, and keep this party going. But really, we're here all night long, and we're going to keep the party going.
Tip your waitresses. Hey, that bike looks familiar. That bike looks familiar to you. Look at this bike. This is a 22-karat gold complete bike. Woody, you're gonna be jealous. This is, I mean, everything is done to a T. I mean, except for spokes.
Sorry, man, I'm not good with
that. But other than that, I think, look at how pretty, I mean, even the decals are gold. I don't even want to touch it. It looks too pretty. It looks too pretty. Embroidered bar pad. Embroidered in gold. Might have some gold in it. It's got an EF Radelaide sprocket on there. It's got a picture of me on the side. Yeah. You know how long this takes to build a bike that looks like this? Unbelievable. And then a display that it's on that says everything. This is how you show a bike. I mean, I'd have to try to find something wrong with it, which I think is gonna be really hard. I'm looking now and I don't see anything wrong. I have to touch it, but I don't want to touch it. So, anyhow, awesome. I'm gonna jump all the way over. You lay next to him. He'll get real close because I've never done this before. Yeah, don't look because you won't want to say, get closer. Closer. He won't bite. Don't move. Jumping over two people, no ramps. Don't give it away. You want to be a takeoff or landing? Landing. Not what I would have chose.
Oh God.
You guys, don't move. Here comes. I just jumped over two people. No ramp. Hey, don't go nowhere. I'm not done. Did I do that right?
No.
No. What was I supposed to do?
Jumping with the bike.
With my bike? Here come. Don't move. I jumped over with my bike.
I'm done. I'm
on my bike. Oh, look, he's done. He's. Oh, come on. This will be fun. I'll give you a sticker if I land on you. It'll be cool. Don't get scared. Like I said to those guys, you know, if I hit you, I'll give you a sticker. I'm almost out of stickers. Not saying anything. Yeah. Don't move.
Don't move.
is something you have to do on a daily basis. Sometimes you have to think about the next trick you're gonna do. If my brakes worked, I'd be able to do that.
Okay guys, so for those that were here last year would know that David Garland here made up a really crazy Eddie Fiola EF Proformer guitar. We had the pleasure of seeing it being played on the night, and if you were here, you heard me sing a rendition of Who the Fuck Has Got My Lighter. I don't know if you remember that. I don't remember it, but it was pretty cool. So there was a deal done, and I'm going to hand the microphone over to David. He didn't know he was going to be talking, but he's going to explain the deal that was done and what's happened to get us to this. You can talk.
Okay, so yes, the guitar I made last year was a tribute, obviously, to Eddie. For those that don't know, I make themed guitars, 57 Chevys and 59 Cadillacs and anything that's resembling Ducatis. I've done all sorts. So I keep challenging myself to do something different. And the whole idea was, first of all, I contacted Bob Harrell and I said, I want to make a BMX guitar. He never replied. I messaged him again. He never replied. And then obviously Radelaide was coming up. So it made sense to contact Eddie. He was straight back at me and said, I'd be honored for you to make a guitar as a tribute. So that's what I did. So last year I made the GT tribute guitar, which was had a little bit of EF on there, a little bit of AliKat, a little bit of the GT. And in my mind, it was like, I'm not gonna sell this. And then obviously Eddie fell in love with it. We were down on the stand. He came up to me and I'll never forget that moment. He said, so I said, you're not having that guitar. He said, no, I'm gonna make a deal with you. He said, I'm going to give you my bike. As soon as he said bike, I shook his hand. Didn't get no further. I said, deal. He said, I'm going to give you a year to make the guitar. So he's really back because of me. So you've got to thank me. That's the reason I'm back.
That's our guitar, guys. We
made the guitar. Don't start. that was the quickest 12 months ever. That's my side of the story. Eddie's side of the story.
That's pretty much it. I mean, I don't know if David realizes also what he got. I know what I'm going to get. This is what I seen last year. The guitar was beautiful. Everything that he did to it, that how many hours he spent on this guitar, over 300 hours, man hours, on building this thing. But this bike that he has now, is one of my EFs. And the problem was with that bike, it was a double numbered bike, so I couldn't sell it. It's number 35, and there was already a number 35 out there, so it's a misprint, and he has a misprint bike. I've been riding this bike. It's been to England. It's been around the world. It's I've done everything on this bike, and now he owns it. And
it's just over there, too, by the way.
It's right there. So, I mean, it's the same one I rode last year, and it's priceless. Just like this guitar is going to be, and I can't wait to see it. I've seen glimpses of it.
No one's seen it. The whole idea was when I make a first design, it becomes 00, it's a prototype. So the next guitar had to be number one, obviously, an upside down number one. But what I've done since then, I've invested in a few different machines, CNCs, as you'll see on the Goad bike, there's a lot of engraving on there that I've done. So on this one then, there was a few things on the other one. He said, what would you change about it? And at the time I said, I think I'd leave it as it was. But then I got to thinking about it, the GT sticker that was on the front of mine I wasn't happy with because the painter sort of cut around it and I just wasn't happy the way that sticker was. So I engraved the GT wing. I'm not going to give too much away, but the rest of you see that this, all singing, all dancing, compared with the other one, is a lot better than the last one I made. There is footage of it being played. A good friend of mine, Chris Finnen, some people may have heard of him. He's a blues legend. I took it to his house last night. I have videos ready to go. So as soon as everyone's seen it, I'll post the videos of it being played last night. Playing slide guitar on this thing is incredible. When it goes to Sydney, I think there's plans over there for it to be played over there as well. So, are you ready?
Awesome. You guys ready to see this guitar? Yeah! Come on. I gotta remember that. I gotta bring this all the way back to California, and I gotta. Luckily, we have gotten rid of a bike out of a bike box, and now we're gonna stick a guitar back in the bike box.
You should see how hard it was to try and find a case to fit this in. And he's got his own stand, he's got a special stand for it. So here we go, a little bit at a time.
Drum roll.
So here we have the Fulfil.
That looks good.
Here we have, which is symbolic of the, if you remember last time, the little video clip that I did, I asked Eddie, because a lot of people ask, what's the symbolic about the four hoes? Should it have three hoes on the dropouts? This is the actual pattern. So this is a kind of a nipple twister, not a knob turner because they're close together. Up here, okay, so you, first of all, turn over, show you their back.
That's awesome.
Down here, it says something like AliKat Eddie Fiola, serial number 01 upside down, handcrafted in Radelaide, South Australia, December 2017. So there's this little EF's been engraved. This one, different to mine, has a yellow inlay neck. The other one didn't have that. Since then, I've learned how to engrave on truss rod covers. So the little EF's on here. You got the wing at the top, the little GT wing. But there's just so many subtleties on there, which are. So I want to hand that over to the man himself. But there's one thing missing. You can't have a guitar without a guitar strap.
I wish I knew how to play. I am strumming. Now I have to learn. I'm going on YouTube.
So just one other thing, custom made. So there's two of these, there's two guitars, so one needs to be signed. One goes to my guitar, which is in a showcase, I'll never sell that. I'll never ever bring myself to sell that guitar, to sell that bike. Even the gold one, if the money was right, I'd sell it, and you move on, you do something else. But like Kid put to me this evening, that looks really, not put the head nail on it, you know, he said that that is the Holy Grail. And it is. And I'm chuffed a bit with it. And I've changed the brakes to the proper way it should be, with a front brake on the right hand side. But other than that, no, it's, I'm delighted with it, so.
Well done, David.
Thank you very much.
He's gonna put a strap on.
Eddie Van Halen!
Thank you. Awesome.